Welcome to NonstopNeuron.com, where learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. In this video, we will talk about excitation contraction coupling in smooth muscles. Let's get started. This is a schematic diagram of smooth muscle fiber. Calcium ions play a crucial role in the contraction of smooth muscles. And most of the stimuli that cause smooth muscle contraction do so by increasing calcium entry into the cell. So our discussion starts with the entry of calcium into the smooth muscle fiber. There are two sources of this calcium: extracellular fluid and sarcoplasmic reticulum. Extracellular fluid is the main source. But there are some interesting things to know about sarcoplasmic reticulum as well. The sarcoplasmic reticulum in smooth muscles is not as well developed as in skeletal muscles. It lies near the cell membrane. Close to them, the cell membrane forms small invaginations, called cavioli. These cavioli contain calcium channels. When action potential reaches the cavioli, these channels open and allow diffusion of extracellular calcium into the cell. Some of this calcium goes to ryanodine receptor calcium channels located on sarcoplasmic reticulum and opens them. Their opening allows diffusion of sarcoplasmic reticulum calcium into the cytoplasm. So this is how calcium enters the cytoplasm. This process in smooth muscles is analogous to what happens at triad junctions in skeletal muscles. There also, the entry of extracellular calcium from T-tubules increases calcium entry from closely located sarcoplasmic endoplasmic reticulum. Now moving towards the contraction part, the entry of calcium increases the calcium concentration inside the cell. Inside the cell, the calcium binds with a protein called calmodulin. The activity of this enzyme is modulated by calcium, hence the name calmodulin. And its complex with calcium is called calcium-calmodulin complex. Next, we have an enzyme called myosin light chain kinase. The calcium-calmodulin complex activates this enzyme. Now it's time to bring in the contractile machinery, the actin and the myosin filaments. The myosin molecule has a regulatory light chain in the neck region. It regulates the activity of the myosin head. Did you notice any connections in the names here? This chain is light chain, and this enzyme is light chain kinase. So as per what kinases do, this kinase phosphorylates the regulatory light chain. This phosphorylation increases the ATPase activity of myosin. The ATPase activity is a part of the myosin cross-bridge cycle. So when this activity is present, the cross-bridge cycle can occur. The cycle keeps happening as long as this regulatory light chain is in a phosphorylated state. This produces muscle contraction. So this is how the excitation leads to muscle contraction in smooth muscles. Now let's talk about how this process is terminated to cause relaxation of the smooth muscle. First, the closure of calcium channels prevents further entry of calcium into the cell. Also, the calcium pumps on the cell membrane pumps calcium out of the cell, and pumps on the sarcoplasmic reticulum pumps calcium back into the reticulum. So cytosolic calcium concentration falls. So calcium dissociates from calmodulin, and the myosin light chain kinase also returns to the inactive state. To remove the phosphate from the regulatory light chain, we have a special enzyme called myosin phosphatase. It breaks phosphate off from the light chain. In a non-phosphorylated state, the ATPase activity of the head is lost, so myosin cross-bridge cycle also stops. So this is how the entire process is reversed. Now let's have a quick summary. The calcium for smooth muscle contraction comes from extracellular fluid, as well as sarcoplasmic reticulum. Inside the cell, the calcium binds with calmodulin, and then this calcium-calmodulin complex activates myosin light chain kinase. This enzyme phosphorylates the regulatory light chain of myosin, which restore the ATPase activity of the myosin head. This allows the myosin cross-bridge cycle, producing muscle contraction. To reverse the process, the calcium is pumped back into the extracellular fluid and sarcoplasmic reticulum, This inactivates myosin light chain kinase. And the phosphate from the regulatory light chain is removed by myosin phosphatase. That's it for this video. To support the creation of these videos, share them with all your friends and colleagues. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.